Hi, and welcome to The Scene. We're up at TRU today, and I'm here with Elizabeth Warner, and she's a fine arts student in her final year. How are you doing? Nice to meet you.
I'm good. Nice to meet you, too.
So tell us a little bit about how you got interested into the arts and how it kind of started for you.
So I've always been interested in the arts. In high school, I was taking different art classes. So when I graduated, I knew that it was something that I wanted to go into. So I started going to school at the University of Calgary and then transferred here to finish my degree.
So tell us about your space.
All right, so we have this whole room for all of the fourth year students, and we've split it up into different studio spaces, but I get this nice little nook in here.
So how would you describe your art and the different things you do to somebody that hasn't seen any of your art?
Well, I work in a different range of mediums, from photo to painting to sculpture, but lately I've been combining them and working on video pieces. So I'll sculpt them and then paint them, and then I get to make a video as well.
I understand you had a marionette or more when you were young.
Yes, I had started a small collection when I was younger, visiting my grandparents in Vancouver, and me and my sister would play with them a lot when we were younger and do little puppet shows for our parents. I would always try to make my own marionettes, but I couldn't really do that successfully. So when I started here and I had an opportunity to work in the wood shop, I decided it would be a good time to actually make those puppets, and it just kind of escalated from there. You hold it by the back stick here, and then when you tilt your hand back and forth, it allows the legs to move up and down. And then the two arms are on the same length. For the first ones I was doing, I was working with basswood, so I would get the like square chunk of wood, and I would draw my idea on there, take it to a bandsaw, cut it out, and then with chisels or with Dremels, try to shape it down until it was the rounded shapes that I wanted. And then once the wood was done, I would connect the pieces with either string or metal loops, and then I would make the clothing and then figure out a way to suspend it as a puppet.
So do you always make the marionettes out of wood then?
I started with the wood, but I've moved on to a oven-baked clay, partially just for practical reasons, but also I like the freedom that I have with it because it's far easier to get the tiny details of the clay than it is with the wood. So I'm mainly working with the clay now on them.
So tell us about how you develop your characters, and you obviously put a little bit of yourself into these as well.
So most of them are based from real people. I've done quite a few self-portraits, which were a really interesting place to start because I really had to create like an icon of myself through it, which seems a little vain, but it was really good self-discovery doing that. So I had to try to create like even the clothing that I was going to wear, what is the one thing that I want to show myself as when I make myself into it. And then I settled on the boots and the backpack mainly as my two main icons. So in most of the puppets of myself that I've made, those images keep appearing. The process of sculpting it has been a little different each time. There's a lot of time spent staring at faces, which I wouldn't normally do. But you learn a lot through each puppet, like how the face works and different expressions and which expression you should choose to make on the puppet, because it's going to be a completely different puppet in the end, whether that smile goes up a little bit more or not.
So do you enjoy working, describe or developing characters that are more human, or do you enjoy the animal kind of aspect or combination?
I like working with the humans when I'm exploring different subjects. I've made quite a few animal-human hybrids. It's more as a fun, light side of it, but I would like to try to combine the two in my fine art, but right now mainly the the animals are for commissions or for certain events that require them to be animals. But it's a lot of fun working with the animals too, because they don't have the baggage that humans have when you bring into it, so they're free to be whichever character they turn out to be in the end.
You do with marionettes is very interesting. We don't see that very much anymore. It's great to see someone continuing that now. What do you get out of it? Why are you going that way?
Well, I really like that it is something that you don't see a lot, but it is something that most people do remember from when they were younger, from stories that people have told them. And a lot of my work, I'm focusing on memories and nostalgia, so I think it's a really good medium to work in, because just seeing the marionette itself brings you back to that place, and then I can continue, once you're there, to bring you where I want you to go through the puppets.
I think a lot of people, I remember as a kid too, having a little hand puppet
and
doing little shows when I was like barely old enough to talk, kind of thing. So I think a lot of people, like you say, can relate to that.
And it's interesting too, because I've noticed a lot of the younger generation, like younger than me, the puppetry isn't really something that they're familiar with because there's no electronics in it. So it's really interesting to show the puppets to someone younger who's never seen anything like that, and to show them how they can move just through what you're doing. In my class, we were investigating a lot of the falseness of memories and how they can't be exactly the same as the first time the event happened. So I wanted to kind of show that in film, but the film itself would kind of be false as well, because going down and recording a memory I already had was creating something false to begin with. I started with memories as well, but I was looking at how memories and reality can never be the same, so there's always going to be some sort of variation between them. So I tried to take videos of actual footage of me going to the ravine and drawing, and then I recreated it through stop motion to show my memory of the place, so the landscape that it was in was imagined based on a real experience, and so were my actions. But I think it's really interesting, because even going down there and filming it was an entirely true experience, because the real experience happened before I could go and film it. So it's like different layers of memories and kind of the changes between them as they go along.
Nice. It seems like a lot of work. When you say stop motion, are you recording one frame and then moving slightly and then recording another frame to put together a series?
Yes, it takes a long time to do it, especially while I'm working out the kinks of how to do it. They like to fall over and I have to start the 3-hour process again. I've also worked with other displacements of things. I did a series of a half deer, half humanoid in the wilderness. And I also did a series of myself as a swamp creature. And that was displaced as well from a normal situation.
Besides your fine arts work here at TRU, you're involved with some other things in the community. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Okay, so next week I am opening a show at the TRU Gallery called Identity Through Landscape, and it's a show that I'm curating through local artists, and it really explores their personal connection to the landscapes that they see every day, whether it be nature ones or interior or suburban landscapes, and how their personal and their national identity are shaped through going through these similar areas as other people. So that's really exciting. It's going to be on from October 9th to the 26th. And then I'm also involved with Arnica, the artist-run center, and that's downtown on Seymour Street in the old court building. So I'm on the board of directors for that, and Arnica is an artist-run center, so it's run by a lot of volunteers, and then we finally have one paid employee. So you have an opportunity to come down there and volunteer and sit in on the gallery, put up the shows, and then we also have different workshops and events that we run through the gallery as well. So being on the board, I help with fundraising and we write grants and just try to keep the gallery afloat.
Looking ahead into the future, where do you see yourself going?
Well, I would like to continue with the videos, working with marionettes and with stop motion. And I'd like to go on to get my master's degree in a few years. And then I'd like to either teach or continue my artist career or go into curating.
So working with your art, how does that make you feel?
I'm really happy doing it. It's something that I can't imagine myself not doing. It makes me really at peace and kind of gives a sense of belonging when you're in the piece, because you're the creator of it, so you need to be there for it to be possible.